So, good morning to all of you. Today I'm going to start Unit 4, that is Web Applications and Security. Most of you must have watched through during online class, but those who hadn't seen it, for them I'm just posting this video. Let me show you how it can be done through Control Panel. In the search box, you will type their Control Panel. So, we all are capable of handling Windows easily, but there are people who are having some difficulty or some kind of impairment because of which they are not able to use Windows easily. For them, Windows provided some additional accessibility options which can be used, like many kinds of impairments are there: visual impairment, hearing impairment, physical or motor impairment, learning disabilities are there. So for those kind of people, Windows provided these features so that Microsoft provided these features so that it can be used easily by them also. Okay, so how can you access these options? You will go to Control Panel by typing in the search box here, and there you will get these options: ease of access, the last one, the towards the right hand side, the bottom one is ease of access. Click on that, and here all the options will be shown. Okay, like those who are not able to view the things clearly on the screen, they can use this speech recognition option. So whatever they are instructing to the system by speaking, that will also be recognized with the Windows. Another options are available here. So click on this ease of access center. All the options will be shown here under different tabs or categories. Okay, so the frequently used ones are magnifier, narrator, on-screen keyboard, and set up high contrast. Magnifier means something, suppose this window which I have opened here, and there are people who are not able to read the content easily since it is written in very small font. So it can be magnified for them. It's not like that the whole screen will be magnified or you have to drag it from this place to that. If you want to read a particular part, suppose this quick access controls only, this part only I want to magnify. So there is an option through which you can magnify it. Just click on that and the sub menu will appear where it will ask to which percentage you want to magnify. Okay, and the brightness and all options will also be shown. Suppose I want to increase it to some, suppose 400. Can you see this? So that part has been magnified so that the person who is having some visual impairment, not able to see the small fonts on the screen, they can magnify it, and then the things will be clearly visible to them. And once it is done, they can zoom out again. Okay, so this was about magnifier. Same way, if you want whatever things are going on the screen, it should be narrated so that it can be heard by the person who is using the computer. So you can have this option of narrator. Just click on start narrator.
Starting narrator dialogue.
This
okay.
Option.
Button. Alt
okay.
Plus
now, whatever you will do, it will
narrator
be...
keyboard changes.
Yeah.
We've updated the narrator keyboard layout so it more closely matches ease of access. Narrator win. Narrator heading level 1. Scan. Welcome to narrator. This is narrator home, where you can get help, access your settings, and learn about new features. Narrator is a screen reader that describes aloud what's on your screen, so you can use that information to navigate your device. To start or stop narrator, press the Windows logo key plus Control plus Enter. Explore the sections below
okay,
to get
so
started.
Exit it from here.
Exiting narrator.
So this was about narrator. Whatever things, even some videos are there in which the narrator can tell that what things are going on, and the people who is having the visual impairment, they can hear it and they can understand. It's not available with all the videos, but some videos only it is available. Then the there are people who have some physical impairment. Their fingers are stiff. They cannot move the fingers easily. So the using the physical keyboard becomes difficult for them. They can go for this on-screen keyboard. Once you will click on this, you will see the same type of physical keyboard. A picture will appear on the screen which can be used. It's not a multimedia keyboard, but all the basic things are available on it which can be used just by holding the mouse and pointing to that particular character. It can be done easily. Okay. Next is set up high contrast. Click on that, and all the options, like I cannot view on this since the contrast of the screen is too low, brightness is too low, we'll have to increase it. So that can also be done from here. Next is explore all the settings. One by one, we'll enter inside all these options and I'll show what options are available. Basically, these four are available everywhere, but ways will change. Like use a computer without a display, click on that. What if you are not able to view the things correctly on the screen? What things can be done? You turn on that narrator. Turn on audio description, which I was talking about. Then in some of the videos, if it is available, whatever things are going on in the videos, it will be told by the narrator that now currently video is showing this particular thing. Okay, next is you must have noticed that while working with any of the window, in between some of the animations are coming, which disturbs the people. So if you want to make those animations you want to hide those animations from the screen, then you can take help of this option. Turn off all unnecessary animations when possible and after how much seconds. Like once the animation came on the screen, after how much seconds that particular dialog box or whatever screen is there, it should be hidden. It can be set from here. So I'm not making so many changes to my system because once I'll make it, it becomes very difficult to bring it back. If you're doing it at home, do one thing, you write the changes which you're making so that you can undo it again in the next attempt. Okay, so next one is your make the computer easier to see. Again, similar kind of options. You can choose to increase the brightness of the or the theme which is compatible with the user, that can be shown there. Narrator, then audio description. Make things on the screen larger means the font. Earlier in that magnifier option, the screen was getting magnified. If you want the font and all to be increased, then you can change, take help of this one. Okay. So next is there, make the computer easier to see. You click on that, you will get the options which I have already told. Then here one more option you will get, that make the focus rectangle thicker. Wherever you will click, that particular portion will become bigger in size and you can use it. Turn off all the unnecessary animations when possible. So all these settings can be done according to the requirement of the person and then it can be used. Once you will choose any new setting, the apply button will get highlighted and then you can click on OK button. Next we have use the computer without a mouse or keyboard. Use the computer without a mouse or keyboard. Here you can use on-screen keyboard, like physical keyboard I don't want, so I will click on use on-screen keyboard and after that apply and then OK, and accordingly this on-screen keyboard will appear on the screen and you can use it. Another thing, avoid using the mouse and keyboard. Here you can use the speech recognition. You will click on that and it will ask you for the mic. Once you will click on that, this will start, and when you will make it on, whatever you will speak, it will be, you must have seen it in mobile phone and all, whenever you click on that, your voice is getting recorded and the system or the device where you are starting it, it understands it. So same way it can be used here also. Next is make the mouse easier to use. For that, another option is there. Just move out of this area and ease of access center, and here you will get that option, use make the mouse easier to see. You click on that and here you will get the option to increase or change the mouse pointer so that it is clearly visible on the screen. You can take any one of these. Then turn on mouse keys. You can allot here when you will click on setup mouse keys for different keyboard shortcut and all. Speed can be controlled, numlock key, how it has to be used, all those buttons will be shown and accordingly the changes can be made. Then you can try it one by one according to your requirement. Then we have there only in make the mouse easier, another option is there. Yeah, activate a window by hovering. Hovering means like this. We are moving the mouse pointer on an icon. Now currently what happens, whenever you double click on any icon in any of the location like desktop, my documents, the particular option or the program gets opened. But if you want that, I don't want to double click, simply you hover means you move the mouse in that particular icon and the program will get opened. So in that case, you'll have to activate this option. Okay, so right now I'm removing it. Then Next is turn on the sticky keys. Sticky keys means sticky keys like suppose your system is hanging. So the shortcut key which you use control plus alt plus delete for rebooting the system. So sometimes what happens, there is stiffness in the finger of people. So in that case, if you're making that sticky keys on, turn on sticky keys option, you will get inside that here. Turn on sticky keys, turn on mouse keys there. Yeah, here you will get it inside, make the keyboard easier to use. Click on that and here you will get turn on sticky keys. So press keyboard shortcuts such as control alt one key at a time. What happens? All these three keys you have to press together. Then only this option of rebooting or opening the task manager works. But if people are having some problem in their fingers and they cannot use or press all these three keys together, so if you will keep turn it on, you can press all these keys one by one and they will perform the same function when you're pressing all these keys together. Like once control key will be pressed, then alt key will be pressed and then del key. And you can specify there for how much seconds it should work. Okay, turn on sticky keys, then how many times shift keys press, then what does it mean? All those things can be used there. Then next is turn on filter keys. Sometimes by mistake, what we do by mistake, now we keep on pressing a single key again and again since we have some stiffness in our fingers. So we can make it on so that computer will ignore the multiple presses of the keys and it will be treated as a single key press. Next is turn on bounce keys. While filter keys avoid problems in case of accidental multiple depression of a key, sometimes you may wish to press a key more than once and not want the computer to ignore the key presses. Just opposite of filter keys will be the function of bounce keys. There if you will make it on, so if you are pressing shift key twice, it will be considered as you are pressing it twice only. It will not be considered as single press. Okay, and for how much minute you are pressing it, that will also be taken into consideration. Then we have used text or visual alternatives for sound. All the things together in one place will be there. And then it will be here, this one. All those options which you used will be here in one window only. So all those things can be done easily. And this is basically used for people who are having that hearing problem. Okay. So this use text or visual alternatives for sound. This option can be used for those people who are having hearing problem. Okay. Then last one is make it easier, where all the options till now which I have shown all will be there in a single screen. So all these things you can try the settings, and wherever you feel difficulty you can ask me. I'm not making any changes in my computer because it will be difficult to undo again because I'm not noting it down anywhere. If you try it, note down the changes you have made and then you undo the changes. Okay, so thank you and have a nice day.